Councillor John Lyons.
Thanks, Ard Vara. And before I nominate, have the pleasure of nominating Councillor Tina MacVeigh, People for Profit Councillor for Cumann Kimmage, for the position of First Citizen of Dublin City, I would like, on behalf of the People for Profit Group, to thank you this evening and pay all due respect to you for your time over the past year as a very passionate, energetic, enthusiastic and always smiling for a citizen, but particularly in relation to your advocacy, your continuation of the work of your predecessor, Councillor Bourke, in highlighting the obscene homelessness crisis in the City of Dublin, and trying, within the limited role that is the First Citizen, trying to have real action occur to address that situation. But also, Ard Vara, and it is a word I hadn't used up until last year, Ard Vara, your hugely important work in relation to the battle to preserve the Moore Street battlefield site. Your convening of the Moore Street Forum has been essential, I think, in the battle to not only hold the unelected officials in Dublin City to account, it's been a vital space in which we've been able to have a good discussion about what we want to see happen on what is one of the most important historic sites in 20th century Irish history. So I want to commend you for all that work, and hopefully that work will continue into the next year. But just to say to my fellow councillors, in nominating Councillor MacVeigh this evening, I do think we need to step back and use this evening's election as a moment to pause, to reflect on what our role is as elected representatives in Dublin City, to look at the role of the City Council, of local government, the funding of the City Council and the functioning of the City Council, because I do believe we are actually in a crisis. We can kind of get lost in the minutiae of monthly meetings and not take time to pause and reflect on what actually is our role and what is happening across the City of Dublin and, of course, across the 26 counties. And I do think it's quite obvious that we live in a highly centralised state regarding the distribution of power and resources, with the local government system in a subservient relationship with central government, dependent as we are on state funding for both day-to-day spending and capital investment. The real decisions regarding society's priorities and needs are taken at a national level, and the decisions are taken by so few people who pay scant regard to the concerns of the majority of the people out there, preferring instead to take instruction from the banker, developer, business lobby, and of course from the bureaucrats of the neoliberal EU institutions. The decisions taken by successive Irish governments since the €64 billion bank bailout of 2008 have led to a deepening of inequality, deprivation and misery for many of our people. The past number of years have seen savage cuts to public services, new inequitous indirect taxes and charges, all imposed under the guise of living within our means, an insult to the intelligence of every single sentient being living on the island, who is well aware that the state poured €64 billion of public money into six private banking institutions in 2008 and told us all that we were going to pay for it all again and again, year after year. At a city council level, this has led to a diminution of local democracy and a decimation of the public services the city council once provided, as the neoliberal agenda from national government assured the privatisation of not only our waste services, but the virtual cessation of public housing provision and the attempt to commodify and commercialise the water and sanitation services the councils once controlled and provided. So bearing all this in mind, is now, this evening's election of the First Citizen of Dublin, not a time to say stop, to call a halt to the charade that is local government, and to begin again, taking a radical reforming role and put it up to national government to say we are not going to continue rubber stamping their bad policy decisions. This is clearly what the people want us to do, to sort out our water and waste services, to build and maintain good quality public housing. It is quite clear that over the last two general elections and the 2014 local election, the people have declared that the days of the old politics and the establishment political parties who preferred to bail out bankers and bondholders rather than protecting our people and public services, those days are over, and the people began voting in ever larger numbers for left-wing parties and candidates who stood for a progressive alternative to the vicious austerity that has decimated community and social supports, that has provoked the return of immigration, that has caused the worst housing and homeless crisis in the state's 90-year history. the people of Dublin in particular in that local elections 2 years ago, they spoke very clearly, electing as they did the largest ever number of anti-austerity candidates, handing us a radical mandate to not only oppose water charges, but to demand more and better housing, to hold the unelected officials to account, and to bring transparency and accountability into all of the council's dealings. In this, I'm afraid we have failed. We have failed, and I think that's a shame. We believe that Sinn Féin squandered an opportunity to form a progressive alliance of the left on Dublin City Council in 2014. We believe they deliberately ignored the radical mandate that the people of Dublin not only gave Sinn Féin, but ourselves and Peep for Profit, the Anti-Austerity Alliance, and the many other left candidates, instead choosing to do deals with all of the discredited pro-austerity parties of the establishment, most particularly the Labour Party. This has led to a dysfunctional city council which has done nothing but oversee the further worsening of the housing and homelessness crisis when we needed a radical council to stand up to city council management's bad plans. So, Ardvara, I finish on this. We must use this evening's election of a new First Citizen as an opportunity to collectively declare that local government is in crisis and that we, the elected representatives of the people of Dublin City, from this moment on, are going to demand real democracy by way of the devolution of functions and the provision of a sustainable funding base for the City Council. And I can think of no better person to lead the charge for radical reform than Councillor Tina MacVeigh. A true community leader of many years' experience, she's passionate, progressive, honest, caring and energetic. She's a radical, she's a revolutionary, she's the best candidate as First Citizen of Dublin City, the best placed person to lead the drive for the radical reform this city so badly needs. Thank you, Ardvara.
Michael, have you got a seconder? Michael O'Brien?